So students, today we are going to perform the test of ammonium ions. Okay, so for that ammonium ions, we have this test tube and few reagents with us. Like this, this reagent is NaOH, by mistake it is written as a small h, otherwise it should be NaOH, capital one, everybody knows that. And the second one is NH4OH, we have here, NH4OH also we are going to use. And then Nessler's reagent. Now Nessler's reagent is a reagent whose formula is K2HgI4. Okay, and here I have taken a salt. Now presently I am not showing you the name of this salt. As soon as we will perform, then I will be showing you the name of this salt. Okay, and this salt I take it out in a one of the petri dish. Now what we have to do, first of all we are going to take the salt. We'll be taking the salt in this test tube, in this way a very small quantity of salt we have to take, and in this salt pour NaOH. The indicatory test for ammonium ion is, first of all we need to allow the salt to react with NaOH. Now after reacting with NaOH, you all will see that nothing is happening with NaOH. So we have to observe that. In this way we are going to mix the salt properly, or as it is only a NaOH which is a base, you can just keep your finger here and then vigorously shake it. After shaking, when you will smell this salt, you will get the smell of ammonia. Ammonia smell, it means the smell which is coming from NH4OH bottle, or in day-to-day life, if I'll say that, the smell which is coming from public urinals are also considered as a smell of ammonia gas. Okay, so this is the indicatory test of ammonia gas. Now, how we are going to perform the confirmatory test, that also I'll be showing. Now what you have to do, you have to make a salt solution. For that one we will be taking salt plus water. So now in another test tube, I'll be taking again a very small quantity of salt, and in this one I will be pouring water. I'll be pouring water to it, and just after pouring water to it, mix it properly. And when the salt will get dissolved, then you can pour Nessler's reagent to it. I am having this Nessler's reagent with me. When I'll be pouring Nessler's reagent to it, we should get brown PPT. And students, here you can observe that a complex that is brown PPT is observed. Right, this brown PPT, and this brown PPT shows the presence of ammonium ion. Okay, now from the same salt I am going to detect the acidic radical also. Basic radical we know, that one is ammonium. Now how to identify the acidic radical? The easiest one, what we are going to do, we are going to take a very small quantity of salt, and in that one we will be pouring dilute H2SO4. We will be first pouring dilute H2SO4. As soon as we'll pour dilute H2SO4 to it, we'll come to know, students, you can observe that some reaction is going on, and this reaction is actually the brisk effervescence of CO2 gas, right? When gas is released with bubbles is known as brisk effervescence, and only CO2 gas can release out in this way. One more gas releases out in this way, but that gas is not in our salt, right? So we will be saying this is shows the presence of CO2 gas. When you will pass this CO2 gas through the lime water will turn milky. So in this way we have confirmed that CO3(2) negative is present as a acidic radical in our salt. So let's see the name of this salt, and the name of this salt is, it's a ammonium carbonate. So ammonium we have performed, and carbonate also we have performed. In this way we can identify any salt. Thank you, students.